A new form of exercise, vibration training, might just hold some promise for people of an advanced age, the old folks. I say exercise because it's tough to characterize it like that. Yet, as we'll see, it might provide some similar benefits. An analysis of 34 randomized controlled trials, researchers looked into this unconventional method for improving muscle strength, and they specifically included studies in older individuals because muscle strength becomes more and more of a health concern as we get older. We'll go over the results, some key nuances, and how to use the information at home. I suppose before we get into the analysis itself, we should get some background on vibration training itself. Vibration training is literally a whole body vibration that emanates from a platform that oscillates up and down or side to side. The platform looks like this. Looks like something that you might find in the, I don't know, the Jetsons, but it's actually one used in the studies. So these are definitely commercially available. Essentially, the mechanical vibrations engage stabilizing muscles, engage the nervous system to constantly adjust for frequency and amplitude of the vibrations. There's different versions, standing, sitting, and so on. And although things like resistance training is usually recommended for improving strength, it can be intimidating or implausible for some. So, could this provide a similar benefit? For that, we'll turn to this analysis focused on people who were 60 years and older and included men and women. They focused on lower body muscle strength improvements because this is an area that is of the greatest concern. It's the part of the body that's most affected by falls, for example, which can be debilitating and even deadly. So let's focus on the knee extensors. Those are the muscles at the front of your leg, like the quadricep muscles primarily. Clearly an area of great importance when catching ourselves from a front-facing fall, like tripping. Looking over the data, the different conditions of participants included in the analysis are the headings on the left side. The top being healthy, yet elderly individuals, then sarcopenic individuals, so people with beyond normal reduced muscle function, then two more groups related to frailty. Essentially, people who are in such compromised shape that they may be institutionalized or under constant supervision because their day-to-day function is difficult to achieve. Now, see the zero line there? That's the null effect line. So if the diamond moves to the right, it indicates there's a muscle strengthening effect of the vibration training. So further evidenced in Portuguese at the bottom. And since I'm fluent in Portuguese, I will read it and translate. Vibratio, vibratio, I'm not fluent in Portuguese. Not even a little bit, but it means vibration. Looking, that honestly sounded a lot more Italian than anything. Looking at all these different subgroups over, there is a positive effect for older and healthy individuals and frail individuals, but not for the sarcopenic individuals, nor for the low functionality individuals. The reason being that the diamond is in contact with the null line. Now, there are a variety of reasons for that, but the bottom line is that there aren't enough studies to make a clear assessment, except in older, healthy individuals. Yet, the next question that we have to ask ourselves is how much of an effect? The data is presented in standard format, which means that the interpretation is a bit more difficult. Skipping the statistics lesson, we're looking at a moderate effect across the board, so likely noticeable and worthwhile. Now, another question that we should ask ourselves is if the intensity of the vibration makes a difference. Fortunately, the researchers looked into that too. Before we get to that, I pulled the different protocols across the most effective studies and put together a simple protocol for anyone interested in giving vibration training a shot. It's available for the Physionic Insiders, along with all my other work. The link is in the description if you're interested. Okay. One of the most important variables in exercise and also here is the intensity of the training. In this case, there are a number of parameters that researchers can change, but magnitude is one of the most important. So the researchers split the studies according to which studies use vibration training at a low magnitude and those that trained at a high magnitude. The cutoff was 4.4 G. Let's focus on the biggest data set, the knee extensors again. Here, We're looking at both magnitudes. The left is below 4.4G and the right is above 4.4G. And, well, although, again, limited studies, it doesn't seem to matter. Both work. Again, both are mostly driven by the healthier older individuals, although individual studies indicate some potential benefit in less healthy situations too. Okay, but as far as I know, there's no G meter on these devices, so we have to calculate it, but you can remain calm. I won't make you do the math. I'll give you all the information as needed. By the way, the G stands for gravitational acceleration, which is what fighter pilots and astronauts have to deal with. Well, at least as far as I'm aware. Look for an amendment to this video if that was wrong. I'm no physicist. Obviously, the context is entirely different. We're not trying to flatten Grandpa under massive G-forces as he corkscrews through the sky. It's a hilarious image, though. Okay, a few things before we wrap this up. One, I know the researchers included, 30-something studies. It seems like a lot of studies, but that's because the studies look at different parts of the leg. It's a good amount of consistency across muscle groups, but there's a lot more data that we need to have on these subpopulations of people, like those with sarcopenia, for example. Second, about 50% of the studies use vibration training compared against nothing. So not exactly a shock that we might see an effect. The comparisons against exercise are very weak. So I'm ignoring those. The point being, we don't really know if this is better than resistance training, but we do know that it's better than nothing. And it's not just a little bit better, but noticeably better. I just want to make sure that you're aware of those two important points. Now, how do we use this? Well, G, or gravitational acceleration, is based on a formula. And that formula is dependent on two things, frequency and peak displacement. For a G of 4.4, like we discussed earlier, you would want to set your vibration device to 2 millimeters in displacement at a 23 hertz frequency. If you increase either of those values, you have increased the G. And if you reduce one or both, then you are reducing the G. But as we noted, higher and lower seem to be effective. And as a final consideration, the lowest G used in the studies was 0.1 G, which is very low. But that was used in the frail individuals, which makes sense since you have to be careful as it can be pretty critical. For healthy older individuals, as a reminder, that's defined as over 60 in this analysis, the G was 0.3 at minimum and still effective in that study. Or, like I said, if you want it all conveniently laid out for you, I have a protocol laid out for the Physionic Insiders. Again, link in the description. So, where does that leave us? What's the short version? One, vibration training works for improving muscular strength in people 60 and older with noticeable effects. Two, more data is necessary, but it seems effective for everyone who is reasonably healthy. And there's some evidence that it may also be helpful for people who are classified as frail. Three, evidence currently suggests that any gravitational acceleration, so G, is effective, even very low levels, as we discussed earlier in more detail. But there are other ways of regaining muscle function, even at very advanced stages of life. I cover them in this next video. Thanks for tuning in.